Dude, I'm pretty excited for Final Fantasy XII Zodiac Age. The problem is it's coming out in, like, December of next year. By the time that happens, I'll be playing Final Fantasy XVI with my What a Final Fantasy shirt on. And, you know. I'll forget Final Fantasy XII exists. Well, Final Fantasy XIII was still turn-based. It just looked more action-y. It was a lot like 12. I mean, I guess, no, you can't really say 13 was turn-based. I guess that's wrong. But it was still, you know, close. It wasn't like full-on action RPG yet. It wasn't like full Kingdom Hearts. It was kind of in the middle. But I liked 13. Because once Final Fantasy XII on Steam, that would be nice. I can't wait to play Final Fantasy XII in the Let's Play. That game is so long and has so much, like, quality content. It's just good, man. It's just good. It's just a good one. Now, with even more stacking. In World of Final Fantasy II, you get to stack vampires on top of Cloud, on top of more vampires, on top of Pokemon. Twice the stacking power. Twice the vampire stacking. What's up, Chrysoflax? Did I say that right? I call you Chrysoflax. I have no idea if that's how you say that. It looks like Chrysoflax, because it looks like Chryso and then Flax. Chrysoflax. That's right. I'm right. I'm always right. Yeah, I'm at Final Fantasy II right now in the Let's Play. I've been trying to catch up on the live stream stuff, so there hasn't been as many episodes, but I am slowly churning out the episodes. They're still coming. I just uploaded one the other day. So. Wow, I can already break green? It's not going to give me any points, though. Oh, I blew it. That's right. I don't need green. The whole point of this is to not need green, so. But I would have rather broken it at the end where it's worth like a million points. Now I'll probably get break all materia. Final Fantasy XII is a great game. Don't let anyone tell you otherwise. XII got a lot of flack because a lot of people didn't like the Gambit system. And also the story was not that great. But if you look past that, it's a great game. It has a ton of just amazing content. There's like 50 different hunts, which are like these side quest things where you go fight really strong monsters. And it's just like super duper fun. I personally liked the Gambit system, but I can understand why some people wouldn't. But I thought the Gambit system was great, and what frustrates me is a lot of people are like, the Gambit system ruined the game, when you can just turn off the Gambit system. Like, you don't have to use the Gambit system. Like, there's no one telling you gotta use the Gambit system. You can easily turn it off and control all of your characters. But if you do like the Gambit system, you can use it, and it's really fun. It had some incredible, incredible super bosses. One of the last hunts is like insanely difficult, and the final hunt has 50 million HP. And it was just a great game. I like the characters. The characters are likable. The story is lacking, so the characters end up kind of not doing much. So that kind of sucks. But the characters themselves are likable. Like, I didn't hate any of the characters. I mean, how can you hate Bunny Boob Lady, you know? Everyone likes Bunny Boob Lady, so. But yeah, Final Fantasy XII is a great game. It's not for everyone, but I think there's fun to be had for everyone. Like, I think you won't be... Like, I don't think you can play through XII without having, like, any fun, you know? Like, you're gonna have fun. Maybe you think it's not the best game, but you're gonna enjoy it. If you have a chance to play it, I say play it. And some people love it. Like, there's a chance that it might be your new favorite game. Like, someone just said that it's their second favorite behind Final Fantasy VII. Like, I think it's an acquired taste, and if you like it, you're going to love it, you know? If you don't like it, there'll be a little fun to be had, and you won't waste your time. But if you like it, you're going to love it. You're going to love it. It's a great game. Great game to play with a friend, too. The loot system is really cool. The only thing that I think I truly hated of 12, other than the story that was kind of lacking, but the license board system was kind of garbage. It was like a poor man's sphere grid. And I just don't think it really worked out as well as they thought it was going to. But that's only a small thing. Also, I didn't like quickenings, because quickenings did kind of ruin the game a little bit, because they're so strong that they can just obliterate anything. But a lot of times, I just didn't use quickenings, you know? Just didn't use them, you know? What's up, DH Gibson 2011? Thanks for being a big fan of my YouTube. I'm a big fan of you being a big fan of my YouTube. That's me. It truly frustrates me that 13-2 exists. Like, forget the game, because the game is actually pretty good. I'm just frustrated that it even exists. Because why make it? You make a game, you make Final Fantasy 13 that gets mixed reviews, when all of your other Final Fantasies have been great, and then you're like, meh, let's make a 13-2, and a 13-3, and a 13-4. Like, why? Why would you do such a thing? I don't understand the reasoning. It's like the one that was mixed results with everyone, and then you're like, let's make more! Square, literally, I think every decision that Square has made since, like, Final Fantasy X has just been unbelievably questionable by me. Like, I truly don't get it. I don't really have any way to heal. Oh, I guess I have White Wind. Use White Wind. I think 13-2 was a good game. I think 10-2 was a good game too, even though it ruined my favorite character. And the story was absolutely laughable. The actual game itself wasn't that bad. Could have been better, but like I don't consider 10-2 a bad game. Like, I consider, like, I don't know, E.T. on Atari, or Castlevania 2, or, like, you know, the obvious bad games. Like, I consider those bad games. I don't consider 10-2 a bad game. Like, I had fun playing 10-2. I think that it had a lot of problems. I think that the characters were absolutely laughable, the story was a joke, and a lot of the dress spheres were like, what the hell? But in general, I think it was a good game. It was entertaining enough to keep me playing the whole game. But yeah, just the fact that they make some of them, like, I don't understand. Like, 10 was such a, like, emotional game, and then they're like, oh, let's just make 10-2 and make it, like, a complete joke. And then 13 was a game that not a lot of people liked, and they're like, oh, okay, let's make, like, 10 more. Sounds legit. Zero MP, this kind of blows. That's not what we wanted. So I don't know. It's just kind of, I don't understand the reasoning. And then they, like, make the Final Fantasy VII remake, but they decide to make it action-oriented, even though they said it was supposed to be for the fans. And then they make I Am Setsuna, which is a turn-based, just to laugh in everyone's face. And then they make World of Final Fantasy, which is a game for kids where people want to have sex with you in the street. Like, what? I mean, what were they thinking? I don't understand. So many things about World of Final Fantasy I don't understand. It's like obviously for kids, but then there's like people cussing and there's guys pretending to have sex with you. Like, why? What are they doing? What kind of drugs are they on? What kind of drugs? I mean, really. You have two of the most ridiculously annoying characters ever in existence. You have them walk around talking to Final Fantasy characters, doing weird stuff. You gotta practice with them. That's right. How much health can this thing have? How much health can this thing have? Please. I like how Square continues to make a mockery out of everything they've ever made. Like, they're slowly but surely just making fun of themselves, you know? They make 10-2, which is a complete joke of 10. They make 10-2, or 13-2 and 13-3, which are all ridiculous. And then they finally make a Final Fantasy VII remake, but they make it in the vein of kids today and not people who actually played their game back then. Then they make Eye of Setsuna just to laugh at themselves because they said that turn-based games were out of date, and then they make a turn-based game, so now they're just making fun of themselves. Then they make World of Final Fantasy, which is like this complete joke of just punny nonsense that makes fun of every Final Fantasy game ever made. I don't know if I can do this without any materia. But I don't, honestly, I'm not sure if any of them can hit me, so I guess we'll just sit here for a long time. Also, why does my cursor automatically go to the guy in the middle? It's kind of weird. This might take a while. Do I have something that casts poison? Because I need poison to kill these guys. Also, Mantra Magic is kind of annoying. That's because that's gonna hit me every time. Let's see. Io 2. Don't I have Yeah, Dirty Bomb. That'll work. Yeah! So glad I bought a million of these. Totally worth. They can't hit Yuffie because Yuffie has an innate ability in this mod where every time she gets attacked, she gets a ton of percentage evasion towards that element type. Well, not really element, but basically there's... Oh, Asuna. What is that? You didn't use that last time. Basically, there's, like, attack evasion and then magic evasion. And Yuffie gets stacks of both every time she gets hit with a certain attack. And so she's at full stacks right now, so she is not going to get hit by almost anything. I think Mantra Magic has, like, an auto-hit ratio or, like, 255 hit or something, so that's why Mantra Magic hit me. But pretty much everything else is gonna miss. And she also has high natural evasion, and she also has like 200 dexterity. Because she just has a ridiculous dexterity stat normally. She didn't get a magic stat when she got hit by Mantra Magic. I'm not sure why, but she didn't. Ah, know. It seems like she has like full of both stacks. But for some reason, her magic stacks aren't like going off because she keeps getting hit by magic. It's not doing anything. She's getting hit by it. I don't know, man. Yuffie's broken. Just leave it at that. She's straight up broken. I like how he heals himself, but not his comrades. He's like, yeah, screw you guys. You don't need this. You don't need no healing. I enjoy how Yuffie throws things. She doesn't even look at it. She just like reaches in her pocket. She's just like, whoa! Stop doing that. You did not cast that a single time last time. Oh, that's because he was silenced. That's why he didn't do it. Silence is the way it goes. Silence is the way to do it. Booyah. Just want to thank everyone for coming. Thanks for hanging out with me today on this Black Friday. Special day of the year where everyone tries to kill each other over some Barbie dolls. I'm glad you're here hanging out with me. If you want a chance to win Braid, a really cool platforming puzzle game, if you donate at any point during the stream, you'll be entered in to win. And also, if you want to come back next week, we're giving away Final Fantasy XV, the full game, so you can come back next week and potentially win that as well. And, you know, other than that, we just maxing and relaxing. We're, just doing a little battle arena action. Did you ever use the guidebook for Final Fantasy VII? Yeah, actually, I was sitting right there. Probably can't see it, but it's right here. Right there. And right in my hand. Yeah, the guidebook for Final Fantasy VII isn't too bad. They actually did a pretty good job. Even some of the strategies for the bosses are pretty good. They're pretty basic, but still, they're nice. Like, they tell you, like, hey, grab the water ring before Genova Life, and then you automatically win. And other stuff like that. And they tell you a little bit about the weapons. They give you some... And you know what? Actually, surprisingly, they give some really cool materia combinations in the front of the book that I didn't know as a kid. Like, there's a couple that they actually taught me that I didn't know. So, it's a pretty good guidebook. Much better than the Final Fantasy VIII or Final Fantasy IX guidebook, which were freaking garbage. Hey Death, what are your thoughts on Final Fantasy Tactics, if you have played it, of course? I only played a little bit of Final Fantasy Tactics. I got it free for my PS Vita. I don't remember how. I think maybe it was a PlayStation Plus thing or something. But, I played a little bit of it. It's kind of weird. I'm not a huge fan of games like that. But there are certain games that I am a big fan of that are like that. It's kind of weird. Like, I don't like a lot of them, but the ones that I do like, I love. And I wasn't too much into Final Fantasy Tactics. I think maybe I just wasn't into it at the time, and then I never kind of went back to it. I'd like to go back to it and play it sometime. But yeah, I definitely don't think it's a bad game or anything. It's a great game. It's really cool. I just wasn't too much into it. But yeah, I don't have too much to say about it because I haven't played enough of it to really give it a good. But I've heard that it's great. I think it looks great. It plays great. really cool. I just wasn't too much into it at the time that I got it, and then I kind of got out of mobile gaming. I don't really play mobile games anymore. My PS Vita just sits in a box. Kind of makes me sad. I don't do enough. Well, when I do travel, I'm always like doing things when I'm traveling, so I don't really have time to play it. Like when I go on trips, I'll usually bring my PS Vita, but I'll always play like the same game. I won't like adventure out to play new games because I won't have enough time to like actually play the whole game. Like Tactics takes a lot of time to play and beat. And when I go on a trip, I might have like 1 or 2 hours to play my Vita over the whole trip. So it's like that's not enough time to really like get into Tactics. So. What's up, Heaven Thiruzan? Thanks for coming. Yeah, that is true. I think the guidebook does say to use Quadra Magic Ultima without stating that if you do it on certain enemies, it will break the game. So that's kind of a whoops. It's kind of a whoopsie daisy. What's up, Fat Falcon? I saw a bug where Quadra Magic works with any command like 4x, cut, mind, morph, and even limit break. That sounds pretty fishy. I don't think that's possible. At least not in the regular vanilla game. Maybe in a mod. But Quadra Magic doesn't do anything unless it's a green materia. Now if you use Quadra Magic with Master Magic, you can do some funny stuff, but still only magic stuff. I don't know how you get Quadra Magic to work with a command. It's interesting though. Especially Limit Break, because Limit Break doesn't even have like a materia, so how would you get Quadra Magic to work with it? That'd be really strange. That would have to be quite the glitch. What's your favorite part of the Final Fantasy VII story? What a question. I have no idea. I like the ending a lot. I think Final Fantasy VII's ending was one of like the only games that I actually like really felt the ending was good. Like really, because to me, what makes the Final Fantasy VII story so great is how it ties off its loose ends. There's a lot of games nowadays that don't even really have an ending because they're always trying to like, you know, oh look, it's a sequel, there's gonna be a sequel, so we can't really like end it, you know. So they can't really have like a full ending because they're afraid that they're gonna ruin the chance of a sequel, but Final Fantasy VII, there was never supposed to be a sequel, so they're able to like really make a beginning, middle, and end, and the end is actually like really like satisfying, and it everything builds up to the ending. And that, I think that's what I really like about Final Fantasy VII's story, is that everything built up to the ending. It's not like other games where you do all this crap throughout the whole game, and at the end it's like, oh no, this big old monster, you have to kill it. Alright, you killed it, you saved the world. Like, everything that happens in Final Fantasy VII all leads up to Aeris sacrificing herself to save the planet. That's what the whole game, everything that happens, it all leads up to that moment. Everything... every single thing that happens, it's all about Aeris being like a Jesus figure and dying to be reborn, but not really, but to save the world through her magic. Like, it all makes sense. Once you see Aeris come out and the live stream comes out and she's in the live stream controlling, like, it all makes sense. Everything that you've seen up to this point is like, that's why that happened. There's like an aha moment, and that's what I like about it. Also, I just think the last cutscene was pretty great, and like the whole part at the end with Red 13, like it really cuts off loose ends. It all makes sense. You feel happy when it's over. You're not just like, well, I hope there's a sequel because nah. Like you're content with the ending. Final Fantasy VII is one of those rare games where when you beat it, you're like, I don't need a second one. I don't need a Final Fantasy II. This is it. This was the game, and I enjoyed it. I don't need more closure. It's nice to see, like, preludes and stuff and explain more of what goes on during the game. But, this might be bad. Yeah, it's just a very good ending. Ugh. I also really, really enjoy the Temple of the Ancients. That's a really great part of the game that I've always enjoyed a lot. I'll have to check out that glitch later and try to emulate it. Because I could do it on the PS1 version right now. I'm a little worried about this half HP thing. I don't like the fact that I got that. What's up, Shay Money? Thanks for coming. Glad you're hanging out with us today on this glorious Final Fantasy Black Friday. Oh yeah, the Tifa and Cloud in the live stream is a really great part too. I've always really enjoyed that. I've always also really liked the first part you go to Coral. I don't know why, it's just the music that plays. It plays Dear to the Heart there, I believe. And something about it is just really calming. It's like the calm before the storm, and there's not too much going on, and you're just on the tracks running around trying to get to Coral, and I don't know, it's just like soothing. Go again. iLift just donated $3. He said, if you could name the Highwind, I'd be honored if it was named after me. You cannot name the Highwind, but I will name, from now on, instead of the Highwind, it will be called the iLift. Kind of matches anyway, so it works out. Go take a ride on the iLift. Kind of sounds like Apple made a Highwind. What is this? Is that a plane? No. That's the iLift. It will take you wherever you need to go after you sink it to your butt. You have to plug it into your butt and sink it to where you want to go. Just sink it to your brain. And then it knows exactly where to take you. You have to dick around with iTunes for like 40 minutes and then get on the plane and then it takes you. takes you to your destination. Yeah, I was gonna say no headphone. No headphone port. Headphone. That's what I just said. No headphone port. They're just gonna keep removing more and more stuff from the plane. It started off as like a big ol' plane with like all sorts of stuff, and then they took away, we don't really need these wings. Wings aren't really needed anymore, you know, we're trying to slim it down, so take off those wings. We don't really need food, that's just weighing us down, making it longer to get there, so we'll take off the food. We don't really need a pilot. It's an autopilot plane now, so we don't really need one of those. We don't really need passengers either. Let's just get rid of those too. Still sell it for the same price, but we'll just keep taking away more and more stuff. So we can make it thinner. Because that's what people want. Not enough points. Wow. Oh, you know what? The trash truck is here. That's what that noise is. Because they're supposed to do the trash yesterday, but it was Thanksgiving, so they moved it to today. So now we get to listen to the trash truck go beep, beep, beep. Oscar the Grouch is in there like, what the heck? I'm still sick from Thanksgiving. Journey is to stop Sephiroth in the Android factory. Makes perfect sense. Well, if you like the Final Fantasy VII soundtrack, my next Final Fantasy VII YouTube video is going to be all about the soundtrack. So, stay tuned for that. Pretty excited. It's about 80% done right now. I didn't get any chance to work on it on Thursday because it was Thanksgiving. But it will be done soon. You guys are going to enjoy it. I'm really, really stoked for that video. It's going to be great. I know I keep saying that the soundtrack video is going to come out in a couple days, but I really mean it this time. The problem is I expanded it. So, because originally it was going to be top 10 songs from the soundtrack, but then I expanded it to something bigger, and it increased the amount of workload significantly. But I think it was worth it because I couldn't just do 10. That just wasn't enough. There was too many songs I was leaving out, so I expanded it. But because of that, it's taking a lot longer because it's more than double what it was. Really? I hate the fact that they can still use this attack when they're silenced. It's like the one thing I didn't want him to do, and that's what he does. But who cares? I have 90 feathers. What's up, relaxed kid? Right now we are doing the battle arena to find out what this mysterious mystery prize is in the battle arena thing. We're one attempt away. After this we'll have it. I don't know what it is. It's probably nothing. I guarantee it's probably nothing. Yeah, definitely check out the PS Store. There's some good deals. I bought two games that I was going to play on stream anyways, so I figured why not. Why not purchase them while they're on sale, you know? I really wish I could save before I spend all my battle points, but I can't. Probably tissues, yeah. Yeah, just so you know, we don't talk about the curator on this chat anymore. It's not a thing we talk about. You're liable to get banned. If you speak of the curator. I need to add that to my rules. No talking about the curator. Dio autograph. Can't wait for that. Attack does so much damage, they can do it even though they're silenced. Holy crap, Yuffie, calm down. Holy crap, Yuffie, calm down. Ah, crap. This isn't good. This is not good. This is not good. This is not good. Ho-ho! Got it off. Suck it. Suck on that. See ya, Cash-tacular. Thanks for coming. Glad you're looking forward to the music video. I am too. really looking forward to it. I put a lot of my heart and soul into that video, so it's going to be great. I just hope I get some time to work on it. Maybe this weekend. If not, the next time I have to work on it, it's going to be Tuesday. That kind of sucks. But I should have time Saturday. What am I doing Saturday? I think I'll have time Saturday to work on it. Still have... I say it's 75-80% done, but there's still a lot of work to be done.
Because I have to do
all the visual stuff. That's going to take a while, but... I think I can get it done. Hopefully by mid-next week. Because if I get time to work on it Saturday, then I'll have for sure Tuesday to work on it. And Tuesday I should be able to finish it. What's up, Strife7777Cloud? We're playing you right now. You are the man of the hour. You're getting us this mystery prize. You and you alone. You and your bad breath. This is pretty much all we've done today so far. Started off with the battle arena. We tried a couple different things just for fun. We tried like an Eris build and stuff, but Yuffie's the way to go. Are you really sure? Wait, what? Are you really sure about the Final Fantasy 15 stream you promised? I mean, considering the mess that is World of Honk, are you sure you won't just go insane and kill everyone once it boots up? No promises. Death, I thought about it, and I want to take you out on a date instead of you taking me because I don't want McBoogan Donald's, and I'll pay for the bill, and what's up, Strife? That's probably the best thing I've ever read in my life. But to be honest, I kind of like McBoogan Donald's. And just you saying McBoogan Donald's kind of makes me want McDonald's now. I may or may not have to get McDonald's for lunch now. I'm not going to, though. I'm going to get something quick for lunch because I'm going out to dinner to a Mexicano restaurante. And I'm pretty stoked for it, so I'm going to keep this stomach semi-empty so I can stuff my face with yummy Mexican food. I really hope there's stacking in Final Fantasy XV. I'll probably take it back if there's no stacking. If I can't stack that car on top of my characters, then I really don't know why I'd even play it. Well, this is interesting. They didn't break all my materia. That's really nice. I still get about the same amount of points because I broke my green materia, but now I get to use Bad Breath and make this a lot faster. What's up, JakeTheGamer983? Thanks for following. Hope you enjoy the stream. This fight's gonna be like 5 times faster now. Because not only do I get to silence the guy in the middle so we can't get rid of the poison, but I also get to offer lung their faces off. What the honk? He actually honks the horn in the car. What the bang? If there's no what the bang part, then I'm not playing it. It's not worth the play, to be honest. It's not worth the pre-order if I don't get a little what the bang action. And I get to use Deathblow, which is like quadruple the damage I was doing before because I still have added cut too. That was cool. Just like I planned it. Kill them all at the same time. Alright guys, here we go. Here goes the mystery prize. I bet you it's garbage. I'm fully expecting garbage. Dio's prize set. 3 yellow waves, 3 lucky pills, 3 gospel sparks, and 3 oversoul shards.
Alright.
What is all that? Gospel Spark gives Peerless. That's cool. Lucky Pill gives Auto Crits. And Oversoul Shard is maybe useful? What's the other one? Yellow Wave. Decreases enemy defenses. So they're one use items that are like super strong. I gotta say, I don't really like that. Oh man, I almost have enough for another older soul shard. To buy some SS mines instead. Gotta get me another. You have heightened my interest. Wait, can I do it again? Can I, like, get that prize pack again? Because that'd be awesome. Oops, I didn't mean to pick one of them. I can't even use it? I can't even use the Oversoul Shard. Also, stop doing bad things to me. I can't even use it. How do I use it? Take this. Well, that was a cool animation. I'm peerless, mofos. You can't hurt me, I'm Scotland. Auto crit time. Y'all are gonna feel the pain. Y'all are gonna feel the pain. Yellow pill wave thing. Whatever the heck. I don't even know. Alright, it's better to do 9,999 damage. Booyah! 600 damage! I didn't even do a crit! I thought I had auto crit. I didn't even do a crit. That's not even a crit. Auto crit my ass. This is the worst gift ever. I want it back. I want it back. Take that. See, that's what I'm talking about. That's auto crit. How about Fletch Rockets? Sounds like a sex toy. Boom! Get a critical, dang it! I can't even get a critical! Use your reticle! Oh no, you're right. It's because I was peerless. The items didn't work. Well, peerless is stupid then. Officially. Okay, cool, I can get it again. That's cool. Alright. Well, I'm okay with that, I guess. I'd see, like, my frustration would be if I only had three of each and I couldn't get more, because then, like, I would have to pick what bosses to use it on, and I don't like doing that. I like to be able to have everything for everything, you know? But if I can just get it again, then I'm cool with that. Stupid Peerless! It's all Peerless's fault. Alright. Should we do a chocobo race before we leave? Should we do a chocobo race before we leave? Who's up for a quick chocobo race? Who's down? Who's down for some chocobo race in action? Who's grabbing their all I see is yes, work, and then nah, and then sure, and then quit. Alright, we're doing it. We gotta do a quick chocobo race. What would my stream be without a quick chocobo race? Let's get something good this time. I'll take the elixir. Oh god, we're on super speed mode. Alright, chocobo race super speed edition. We got the super speed glitch going. Alright. We got Lee. We got Fox. Oops, I went backwards. Lee. We got Gray. We got Knight. We got Sammy. We got James. And we got Fox. Who's the fastest? James and Knight are the fastest, but Knight's got the stamina of a drunk hippopotamus. I'm going Gray and Fox and potentially Lee. Yeah, I'm going 1-2-5. I'm going 1-2-5, that's where I'm at. Alright. Put in your votes now. Pick your winners. Two winners. Pick who's first, pick who's second. We got Lee is number one, Gray is number two, Knight is number three, Sammy is number four, James is number five, Fox is number six. Cast your votes now. Everyone's voting for Fox. Do a barrel roll! He looks ready. He looks stoked. I think he's ready to go, to be honest. I've never understood what those numbers mean. What numbers? The betting numbers or this top speed and stamina numbers? The betting numbers, you bet on what two you think are going to win. It doesn't matter if it's first or second, just which two are going to win. So if you vote 1-2 and 1 and 2 come in first and second, whether or not it's 1-2 or 2-1, you win. And then 1 and 5 means if 1 and 5 come in first and second, and then 2 and 5 means if 2 and 5 come in second. So if either of those three happen, then I win. Yeah, it doesn't matter, like, if 5 comes in first and 1 comes in second, or if 1 comes in first and 5 comes in second, either one and you win. And you get three votes. But you guys get one vote. One vote for them all. For it all. Alright, you guys ready? Here we go. Everyone's voting for Fox. Fox is number 6. We'll see what happens. I didn't vote for Fox, so if he wins, I'm totally salty. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. And they're off, and there they go, here comes 3-3s in front, and Fox is, oh, look at Fox, he's going in second place, but he's gonna try to pass 3, oh, he's going around the corner, he's gonna try to catch him in the corner really fast, they're way in front of anyone else, Fox and 3, Fox is going up on 3, 3 is still in first, he's gonna be really hard to catch him up, if Fox is still going, he's still, oh, there goes Fox is in first, he's fast, he passed him all up, Fox is going, he's flying, oh, but now he's in last, oh, he lost it all, he's in last, now they're in space, they're flying, here comes 1, here comes 4, it's 4, it's 1, it's 4 and 1, 4-1 are the winners! And Fox is dead last. Look at him, he ran out of stamina too. Fox had it. Fox was in first and then he blew it. He blew it all. He blew it all. Lee and Sammy. Unfortunately, I did not have the faith in Sammy. I had the faith in Lee, but... I didn't have the faith in Sammy. Alright, we gotta do one more. This one will be normal. And not be super high speed. Alright. We got Mr. T in number one. We got Dan, Trop the Nanny, in two. Look at the difference. 154 to 170. Here we go. We got Dario, Mario's brother. We got Amy. We got Lee, back at it again. And we got Paula, who has a ridiculous amount of stamina. Holy cow. Alright, Dan is the speedmeister, but Paula's got the stamina. I'm gonna have to go with Lee again. Lee's got the moves. I'm going 256. Alright. By the way, did anyone get 1 and 4 right? I don't think they did. I didn't see any 1 and 4s. I don't think anyone had... No one had the faith in 4. It's like no one voted for 4. We all lost. We all lost that one. Alright, so once again, Mr. T is number 1, Dan is number 2, Dario is number 3, Amy is number 4, Lee is number 5, and Paula is number 6. Alright. Here we go. The race has begun. 3, 2, 1... And they're off. Number one and number two are in first. One is now in front. They're going the short race this time, folks. Number three is flying in the lead. He might run out of stamina because he is running like crazy, but he has not run out of stamina yet. Number four is right on his tail. Number two is trailing all the way in behind, but number three and number four are way out in front. They're going around the first turn, and number three is coming up, but here comes the rest of the pack. Number four is falling back, and number six is coming flying in. Number five, right now we got 3, 6, and 5 in the front. Four is leading up the rear. And they're going on a second turn by the giant glowy clam. And number six. Number six has now passed everyone. He's in the lead. Followed by number one and number five. Oh, number three is now in first. Number six is still in first. He's flying past everyone else. No one can catch number six. He is going across the bridge. There's no guy in a boat this time. Now six is running for it. He's running for the final lead. No one can catch him now. And it's six all the way. Six all the way. Followed by two. And then 5, 1, 3, and 4. Who four just finished. He was way behind. He sucked. And Lee blew it. Lee blew it for me. He was close, but he blew it. He blew it. It was Paula and Dan. But hey, I won. I won me a Swift Bolt. Woo. Anyone else get 2 and 6? Cyborg did it. Cyborg won. What a boss. Cyborg did it. Congratulations, Cyborg. TRM wants one more. Alright, one more. We'll do one more. Alright. Ooh, there's a Choco Bracelet. Choco Bracelet on the line. Alright. So in number one spot, we got Dan. We got Sandy in the number two spot. Paula in the number three spot. Knight in the number four spot. Sammy in the number five spot. And bringing up the rear is Robber. Good old Robber. Let's see here. Looks like Knight has the most speed. Paula's got the most... most stamina. I'm going with 3, 4, 5. That's what I'm going for. What's up, Jake the Gamer? How's it going? What's up, Abraham 60? Thanks for coming. Looks like a lot of people are going on the three hype train. Everyone's putting their money in Paula. If Paula fails, everyone loses. Everyone loses if Paula fails. Alright, here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And they're off. Number one is flying in the lead. He's passing everyone. Number four is in the rear. Oh, they're taking a long route this time. It's going to be a good one, folks. I hope you brought your popcorn. Number four is now in first, but number one is passing them all up. Number one's trying to keep up his stamina, but stay in lead at the same time. They're going past lightning bolts. And number six bringing up the rear right now. Number four is close by. Number one and number three are pulling up the lead. But number six is fighting. Number six is fighting around the corner. Now they're going in the water. Can any of them swim? I'm not so sure. Number one is now losing it. The shark is trying to eat number three, but he just barely missed. Number three is now in the lead, but number two is coming back. Oh, the shark just flew past all of them, and now two is flying by. Probably because he's blue and he can swim. Here comes number three. Number three is now coming around the rear. Now they're going around the volcano and the weird-looking candle things that look like they belong in Castlevania. Now they're going by the pyramids. You know, insert Half-Life reference here. And number four is in the lead now. Number three is all the way in the back. Number three needs to really push out all the stops if he's going to get past in this game. Now they're in the final stretch. Final stretch, here comes. Oh, and number five and number six just go blazing past everyone. Holy cow, did you see that? At the end, number five and number six were just like, we're out. Screw you guys. Holy cow, no one believed in number six. No one believed in number six, but he pulled through. Actually, a couple people did. But everyone was on the Paula train. We all got roasted. We all got roasted. Paula came in fourth. Rip everyone. I don't think anyone had 5-6. I don't think anyone believed in that. Paula blew it for all of us. Oh, to Jake the Gamer. Oh, Jake the Gamer had 5-6. What a boss. Our winners. Our winners for today's Chocobo Rally, Cyborg, and Jake the Gamer. Good job. You did it. You won. I lost all the money. Oh. Absolute failure. Paula, what have you done? What have you done to my stream? What have you done to my stream?